Okay, hello everyone, welcome back to Armor Core 3. I am SIMSteven, also known as Master Fenral. And, well, I've kind of been saying this for the last episode or two, maybe three at this point, but we're kind of behind on climbing up the arena, and since the story is starting to escalate, I think from now on until we get relatively close to the story, that I think I'll do like one mission per video, and then fill the rest up with arena battles until we're pretty much caught up on the arena. Because I would kind of like to be around rank B by the time we reach the end of the story. Anywho, we got Steal the Access Program by Crest, and Disable Pulse Generators by Mirage. Now, I said I wanted to do more of Crest's missions, and I don't think either of these have a hidden part, so it's kind of up in the air for me to choose which one I want to do. But I would like to do Steal the Access Program for Crest, since I want to unlock more of their parts in the shop. So, let's get this mission going, and then we'll go on to the arena after this.
Raven, we want you to break into Rihito Laboratory and steal the access program Mirage is developing there. Their reckless attempts to manipulate the controller will not be tolerated. Extensive security measures are in place throughout the lab, so advance with care.
Main system, engaging combat mode.
The program is on one of the lab's computers. Careful in your search.
Thank you.
access program downloaded. Get out of there.
System switched to normal mode.
Okay, not terrible. I did get a little bit of money out of that one, but these ammo expenditures are really getting to my income, which we might fix soon enough. If we do enough arena, we might be able to afford some decent weapons. But, for the sake of actually doing the arena, I have an item in mind. And, big surprise, it's going to be something we used in the past. It's going to be this one right here, the vertical missile launchers, the double ones. Because we loved how these worked back in Armor Core 2. And, we could actually buy this one. I think we actually used this one a bunch in Armor Core 1, specifically in Project Phantasma, once the arena had been introduced. So we could get some use out of this one, and we can afford it right now if we wanted to. And I have been fighting indoors a lot, so I might consider this one over this one. But for the time being, we're going to stick with what we got right now. We're actually going to switch over to green. And we're going to get started on the arena. So let me save real quick, and we'll read off a bunch of bios. And I think we'll do what we did back in Armored Core Massive Arena, where I just read off a bunch of profiles all at once, so we kind of get an idea what these guys are all about. And then, after that, we'll just kind of montage it with some music in the background and speed things up a little bit so we can kind of just slog through these arena battles as quickly as possible. So anyways, actually almost in the C ranks. Very soon we'll be in there. And we should be getting a part once we hit rank C15, I believe. And I think there's one like in the middle somewhere up here, and then maybe once we hit B rank. Which, if you do the math, if you add A1 to A3, so there's 3 A ranks plus 7 B ranks, so that's the first 10, the top 10, I should say. And then you have 15 C ranks, 15 D ranks, and there should be another 30, so that's 40 in total. And then we have the 10 E ranks that exist right now. So that's a total of 40 ranks, or 40 arena battles, or 50 actually. 50 arena battles if you add in your E ranks. So anyways, yeah. Total of 50, but thing is, there's going to be even more than that once we beat the game. A lot more than that, I should say, because I know something, and I haven't let on to what that is just yet. But, one of these days we should go and take care of the new guys that just got added to the arena. Maybe we'll do more of that later this week, because I plan to do this pretty much for the rest of the week, where we do one mission to start off with, and then after that we'll do arena battles until we're all caught up. Anyways, let's get going and start with the profiles, and then we'll get into the actual fights. So this is D2 Hard Edge, AC Revival. Pilot with exceptional skill, but very much in need of a few lucky breaks. The handful of fights he's won are enough to pay for upgrades, but the tough losses are only making him a better pilot. He'll do fine once his luck turns. Question, what's he paying for? Paying for what? Because I've never ever paid for repairs or ammo in the actual arena. I think most of that, maybe he's been doing missions on the side, but we're not actually supposed to pay for arena fights. That gets paid for automatically. Anyways, we have the top D rank opponent here, Sweet Sweeper. AC named Varna, relies on fancy footwork and precision fire to get things done. Meshing his common style with a lightweight AC was a no-brainer, but its lack of armor plating has cost him many battles. He trains constantly to compensate for this. Alright, so he's the top of the D ranks. In order to get to the C ranks, we have to beat Bison. AC name, Gauntlet. Known for his spectacular overboost charges, which are accompanied by constant volleys from both arm weapons, the pursuit missiles mounted on the back of the AC serve him well enough. And though some claim he is just lucky, his actions prove otherwise. And this guy has the dual pursuit missile launchers. I forget what the difference is between a pursuit missile launcher and a regular one. I know if it's like torpedoes, they go down on the ground and then come up kind of near the feet of an AC. Whereas pursuit... Well, they're not the same as multi-missiles, because those exist too, where it's just one warhead that once it gets close to the enemy, it splits into four and comes at the enemy like a claw. But pursuit missiles, I don't know, maybe they're fast? I don't know exactly what the difference is. Maybe they ignite once they get close to the enemy, I don't know. But either way, C14 is comeback. AC Dean Joker, slow starter, it's not often that he finds his rhythm before the tide turns against him. Every now and then, though, something clicks and he's able to regain lost ground. He's earned a loyal following by keeping spectators on the edge. Alright, and I want to at least get 5 in today, so this is C3 Thunderhouse. Probably going to be the last one maybe for today, unless it seems like it's going to be taking a little bit longer. Well, unless it seems like I'm just plowing through these guys, this guy may be the last one for today. Anyways, this is Thunderhouse, AC name Battlefield. Takes great pleasure in using his AC's linear cannon to demolish those that challenge him. When unleashed, the weapon rains down damage and peals of thunder echo across the arena. I've never heard that word be used to describe sound. Peals. Okay. Unless I'm just not looking at the font, and the font is too small. It's a different letter altogether. Anyway, he's made rapid advances, but many still question his skill. And that weapon there on his shoulders. That's a single weapon. And that is the weapon I've been talking about up to this point. That's a super overpowered plasma cannon. Actually, it's a linear cannon based on what this says. That is basically the go-to weapon if you want to get S ranks, especially against tough opponents in the missions. Because it just does so much damage, including against ACs themselves. So I'm going to have to be pretty cautious when I go up against this guy. I'm probably going to have to go into an area with lots of pillars and stuff. Either way, I've already saved, so I'm good on that front. So, let's just get things going with Hard Edge to start off with. And I'm probably going to try and change up the arenas instead of just going into, like, the structure again and again. Or like how I did in Armored Core 2, where I went into the Etal base over and over again. I don't think there's quite a place like that in this game, unfortunately. Which kind of sucks, because I love the Etal base, and there's no rough equivalent of that here. You know what, let's just do a straight up fight in the arena to start off with. And, I must hit the button accidentally. Let's start off with just a straight up fight in the arena, and if I don't do too well, I might switch arenas. But we're going to start here, and well, let's get things going with another music montage! right, and I think that'll do it for today. I did a couple extra, and we got a little extra in the funds department. So 19,000 at this level, so we're doing pretty good for ourselves. Speaking of ourselves, we have a new bio. With a good number of wins under his belt, both arena fans and competitors alike keep close watch on this Raven. Though still too early to make a reliable assessment, we'll see a lot of promise. Look forward to watching him compete at the C level. Okay, so, well, we kind of got 10 more guys ahead of us before we hit rank B. But I am kind of content with getting as far as we have. We're probably about, about the halfway point, I guess. Actually, we've already established that there are 10 people above C rank, so we're actually in the top, top 21 at this point. Either way, we've got two more bios to read, since I didn't actually read them before the montage. So, the guy we just fought, Ox, AC name Parthenon, did, in fact, run out of ammo, as his bio suggests. I noticed he only has that bazooka, and I noticed when I was in battle on the little hub on the bottom of the screen. Actually showed he ran out of ammo, and that's kind of why I won at the end. It was an itchy trigger finger. Limited ammo reserves and target acquisition issues leave most wondering how this pilot ever got as far as he has. He's made improvements to his AC's ammunition stores, but the underlying problems remain. Yes, you lost. but his attacks did do quite a bit of damage whenever they did hit me. Speaking of which, this guy did as well. Ended up fighting this guy twice because, well, he's all grenade launchers. In fact, even his arm cannons are grenade launchers as well. So yeah, I had to play it safe the second time around, and I did. And I ended up winning that fight. Anyways, this is Barshetta, AC name Karma. The polish and grace of his Karma style make him wildly popular with the arena's female fans. Ooh. And he and Midas were close once, but grew apart after your arena career took off. Whenever her name is mentioned, he ruminates about days gone by. Speaking of which, where is Midas in the list? C4, ooh. So we've yet to fight her, but she's apparently much better than her boyfriend, or ex-boyfriend at that one point. Neat. Alright, so I just want to look at her really quick. Does it actually mention? Yeah, the very last sentence, she and Barshetta were close once. But I wonder, maybe we'll fight them both together in a mission someday. Who knows? Both lovers will go down together or something like that. But anyways, who knows? Either way, I almost got a good setup going with this black AC. I decided to put the vertical missile launchers on this one and make this my arena AC. It's got the howitzer on it, and it's been working out fairly well. I have come, pretty low on ammo, except for that machine gun, because, of course, it's got 1,000 rounds on it. So that's kind of why I'm going with the howitzer, just kind of playing the range game with this guy. But I think before I really call this a good AC, I do want to get an extension for it, because part of the reason why the vertical missiles launchers were good enough is because we had the extension parts in the previous games, where we shot extra missiles at the same time. Interestingly enough, I actually took a look off screen, and there's actually a vertical support missile launcher on the extensions. So, well, it says relation missile on the type, but it says on the bottom that it's a vertical missile launcher. So, since obviously I'm using vertical missile launchers on this one, I'm probably going to use that one and have not only the multi-vertical missile launcher on the back weapons, but use the extension as well, and just kind of be a barrage from up high. Either way, that set's almost done, but this episode is also almost done, so we're going to call it a day, save the game, and I'll just say once again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.